I'm Matt Brennan, Senior Investment Strategist and Portfolio Manager for Fulton Financial Advisors and Fulton Private Bank. Welcome to our market update for the month of February 2023. After a disappointing 2022, which saw stocks and bonds down more than 10%, and the worst performance for the benchmark 60-40 portfolio in nearly 100 years, 2023 has kicked off on sturdier footing. All major markets have posted positive performance so far, with major U.S. stock and bond markets gaining ground in the low to mid single digits through January. However, there remain some dark clouds on the horizon. As the Fed nears the end of the fastest rate hiking cycle in history, most analysts are calling for a recession in the next 12 months. In fact, the Wall Street consensus currently sees a 65% chance that the U.S. economy falls into recession at some point during the year. Inflation and rates will remain the key variables to watch in 2023. If we have a recession, it would be the most anticipated one in history, and households and firms are already preparing for what could lie ahead. The path exists, however, for the Fed to thread the needle and avoid a recession. Given the recovery in supply chains and emerging deflation in the goods sector, the Fed may be able to engineer a soft landing, meaning they're able to rein in inflation without tipping the economy into recession, a task that has historically been very challenging. To do so, the Fed will need to see the labor market return to balance in order to dampen wage pressure and ultimately tame inflation. The main issue with the labor market is that firms have far more jobs to fill than workers available to fill them. If we see a reduction in the number of unfilled jobs, rather than outright job losses, the Fed just might be able to achieve their goal. Canceling open positions that were never filled causes little to no economic damage compared to the economic hardship that arises from widespread job losses. Recent data reports indicate this is exactly what has been happening over the last several months, which gives us some hope. Still, the risk of potential recession remains. A review of post-World War II Federal Reserve hiking cycles shows that the majority of cycles ultimately result in a recession. Regardless, we believe investors are best served by sticking to their long-term plan. In the near term, investors can make some tactical shifts that are informed by history to help put the odds in their favor, despite the uncertainty. In the past, stocks and bonds of high-quality companies kept pace when a Fed hiking cycle resulted in a soft landing and significantly outperformed when it ended in a recession. Given that, we believe tilting portfolios towards high-quality companies with stable cash flows is prudent. Of course, you'll want to consider your financial objectives and risk tolerance as you apply this thinking to your current portfolio. Thank you for your time today. We hope you have a happy new year, and I look forward to speaking with you next month.